Welcome to Honest Book Reviews. If you are new to the channel, please subscribe. Today we will be reviewing The Looking for Alaska book by John Green. If you're looking for an intellectual, cultivating book to read, this is definitely the book for you. Throughout, this book is upbeat and has a wonderful pace to keep every reading level entertained. Finding Alaska is about an unpopular young man named Miles who embarks on an adventure to a boarding school looking for something more. They were the equivalent of living, breathing beings as opposed to characters in a book. He has always been introverted, so his roommate being completely extroverted and carefree leads to Miles to grow. Yes, most of the story is revolved around a girl named Alaska, and Miles' attraction to her, and her disappearance, but there is so much depth to the story than just that. If you too are a huge fan of John Green, or coming-of-story novels, this is the perfect book for you. As it turns out, young adult literature is mainly characterized by having a young protagonist, fewer characters, and a limited time span. This novel mainly centers around that character development, however there is enough action to keep the plot moving along, and the story from getting boring. It has already been recognized as such by the Young Adult Library Services Association, having received the Michael L. With exceptionally developed characters that you feel like you know, and a whirlwind of a plot, you won't be able to put this book down. Perfect hair is not an amulet against the potential trials of life, and popularity is insignificant. However, the pace was slow, and even if that not necessarily has to be a bad thing in this case, it made the reading experience hard. When it comes to most of forms of entertainment, whether that be video games, books, music, art, anime, etc. Book 60 Read in 2015 Looking for Alaska by John Green. John Green is one of the most popular young adult authors today, and a book like Looking for Alaska shows why. About halfway through the book, the unthinkable happens, and the rest of the book shows the aftermath, and the search to find out why. Looking for Alaska had excellent characterizations of the title character Alaska Young, the protagonist Miles Puchalter, the protagonist's clever roommate Chip Colonel Martin, and their Asian sidekick Takumi. Not to say there aren't a few aspects of this book that should be avoided, like the heavy underage drug and alcohol abuse. Quick read, as you don't have to work to keep the characters straight as to who is who. The book is like peeling away an onion on each of the characters, little by little, but never fully gets to the inside. The main character is Miles Halter, a high school boy living in Florida with his parents. A poignant story of rebellious teenagers in a boarding school, each with their own challenges and their own vibrant personalities. Some of the content in this book, alcohol consumption, descriptions of sexual acts, might be a bit much for kids under 15-ish, but use your best judgment depending on the person if you're recommending it to someone in that age range. The characters in the story are in that age range, and the book is aimed at the demographic, so it's not explicit or pornographic or anything, but it doesn't shy away from teen sexuality. You think life is going one way, and then poof, you are thrown a 180. They are not perfect like in many YA books, but their characters are well developed, and beauty is found in their quirky personalities. The characters in the book are very smart, and have aspirations to do great things in life. The author obviously has a passion for education and literature, and that was really refreshing to see come across in a YA book as well. Sadly, many high school kids are smoking and drinking and having sex without reading Tolstoy. Incidentally, it is this pattern of behavior that helps to establish Alaska's actions throughout the book, and it's just that incredible. Looking for Alaska is a real, honest account of being a teenager, all things that most teens do, or at least think about doing on a regular basis. This is another easy read by John Green, and yet, it's not an easy read. They are in high school, so it's natural to see the drama and high school romance. If you are looking for a read that has more emotional compacted words, definitely read this. The texts have similar themes, so it gave students of different reading levels the opportunity to share related ideas regardless of the book they read. It is an easy read, so simple literary techniques, but characterization, setting, themes, motifs all could be great discussions from an English teacher perspective. Pudgeth protagonist is the master of last words, so you can learn some historical fun facts as well. The key idea that comes up in the text involves the labyrinth, and figuring out what this is for each of us. The book is split into before and after, with the before counting down to a certain day and event, and the after trying to make sense of life and what has happened. Yes, the characters do naughty things much like any group of teenagers with little supervision. They also do good things like study a lot and try really hard to get good grades in their classes, other than, or maybe because of, the whole heart blender thing. Looking for Alaska is a fabulous book, and also, a huge event happens in the book, and the main character tries to figure out what happened. It just seemed like the author was tired of writing, and just took the easy route out. This novel talks about so much: religion, life, death, philosophy, emotions, drinking, smoking, sex, etc. This book is amazing. If you are a teenager, you must read this, and if you are an adult, and don't have an issue with sex, drugs, and alcohol, then you should read this too. Thank you for watching. Do not forget to subscribe, and leave your comments below.